Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you how to create an animated coloring book from a video. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be looking at video, how to create a cartoon effect in video, and then also we're going to have a look at placing it here inside this book. So this little girl is going to be reading basically a animated book or a living book. So here we go, we're going to start with a video that I just basically open to get a video inside of Photoshop. Just choose File, Open, and then make sure that our timeline here is showing, which we've got at the bottom there. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go into the video group, which is created on a new layer whenever you bring video into Photoshop. So we're going to right click and we're going to convert this to a smart object. So we've got the smart object there, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to duplicate it. Just hit Command J or Control J to duplicate that. And notice we've got two clips, one after the other. What we want to do is change it so they're on top of each other. So to do that, we drag it out of the video group. So go in the layers panel, pull it up until you see the line at the top, release it. Now you've got one above the other. And we just need to select it in the timeline here and drag it over. So now we've got the two stacked above each other. Now what we want to do is we want to create the cartoon effect, which is really simple with video. We can apply an adjustment layer. So first of all, we're going to go to adjustment layer. We're going to the blend mode. We're going to change the blend mode here to divide. And then you're just going to see white. So what we're going to do now is we're going to apply a filter. Now this is the reason we've created a smart object, because we can apply a filter to the video in the smart object and it will affect every frame. So we're going to choose a filter blur. We're going to grab the Gaussian blur or Gaussian blur, however you want to say it. Let's pull this up over here, and we're just going to play around until we get the effect we want. So as you can see, we can go all the way up here and down a little bit, and if we want more sketched, we go a little bit lower. So just find the effect that you're looking for. I'm thinking about there is looking pretty good, and we're just going to play OK. Now if we hit the space bar, we can see it moving, and literally we've created this kind of sketched effect with the video where it's moving, which is awesome. But now we want to put it into our coloring book. Now we can do other things with coloring and stuff if we want, but in this case we're going to keep it pretty simple. So let's just create a curve adjustment layer on the top here. And with this curves adjustment layer, we're just going to play around a little bit and maybe see if we can change this a little bit to get more of our effect that we're looking for. So I'm just going to bring down the highlights a little bit, and let's play around with the shadows. Notice the shadows are not really affecting it much, so we can actually just get rid of those. And we've got a little bit of a stronger effect. I like that better. All right, so let's select the whole shooting match, and now we're going to put this into one smart object. So what we're going to do is just right click and we're going to convert it to a smart object, and we could call this our video. Now you could save this file if you wanted. There's different things you can do, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this smart object and I'm just going to click it and drag it into the tab for this particular image, and I'm just going to release it now. And notice what we've done is we've brought that video smart object into the image. Obviously the image is a much higher res. So what we're going to do is we're just going to hide it for a second. And now I want to just select the book or the area here that I'm going to replace. So we're just going to grab our quick select tool, and there's our quick select tool there, and we can just kind of drag it over the book a little bit to select those areas. If we go over, we're just going to hit the Alt key or the Option key and just clean up that edge a little bit there. Now if you wanted to get a perfect edge, you could do this using the pen tool, but honestly we should be able to get what we want here. Now one of the things, notice we've got a little bit of area I want to select in there. So we could either turn down the brush, which is actually pretty small already, or the other thing is just click on there, and notice we've got an option there for pen pressure. As soon as I touch my pen there, you'll see that little exclamation point should go away. There we go. And so I'm using a Wacom pen, and I'm just going to zoom up a little bit and just very, very gently go in here to select inside these areas. We can include this hand. So once again, I'm just pressing a little bit lighter on my pen tablet to do that, because I don't want to go over too much, and we're just kind of picking that up in there, and same in there. Now you could, you know, be using a lasso tool, or you could just, you know, use a smaller brush and just kind of do that by hand there until you get that exactly how you want it. and it's a little bit stubborn there. And once again, you know, we're going to grab it in there. And almost there. Let's get a little bit. Now, for stuff like this, we're about to go into the Refine Edge or the Select Mask to clean it up. But the other thing you could do is if we hit the Q key, this will take us into the Quick Mask mode. And then in Quick Mask mode, we could actually paint this selection. Now, notice that the mask is there. If we want to change it, we double-click on the Quick Mask. And I'm going to go to Selected Areas rather than the Masked Areas. And I'm going to drop this opacity down just a little bit. And then we're going to hit the Q again. And notice what it does now is it selects there. So I'm going to grab my brush. And we're just going to make a small brush here. And that's with black. And we're just painting here inside that Quick Mask. Just to kind of manually clean this up a little bit. This is before we refine it. And I just find that doing it here gives you just a little bit more control. If you want to get this exact. Now I'm getting a little bit overboard. You know, just for the sake of this illustration, I don't have to make this perfect. I'm just going to give it a little touch there, and that's looking pretty good. And let's have a look around there. We can see the edges of the book. Yeah, it's not bad. Let's clean up a little bit in here. I'm just going to do this by hand. Make sure I turn my opacity all the way up to 110 off pan pressure here, and then that way I can just go in there and just paint that manually. We're still going to refine this, but I just want to kind of get this started this way. It's just going to give us a nice clean selection there. And let's go in there a little bit more. There we go. And there's a little bit in there. Now there are tools in Refine Edge that'll help us with this, but that's good enough. So let's hit Q for turn off the Quick Mask back to a selection, and we're just zooming out a little bit. And now what we can do is we go under Select to Mask. So if we choose the Select here and we go down to Select to Mask, now if we wanted we could hold Shift and that'll bring up the old Refine Edge, or we can choose Select to Mask. In fact, I'm going to bring up the old Refine Edge by holding down Shift, and because that seems to work for harder edged objects here. So I'm just going to give it a little bit of radius there just to kind of smoothen it out. See how it just kind of smoothens out those edges a little bit? And let's have a look at it on black. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create this to a new layer with a layer mask, and we're going to click OK. Now what we see there is there's our book. Now we're going to turn on our background layer right there. Perfect. Now we're going to put together our little animation. So I'm going to turn on the video there. And then what we're going to do with the video is I'm just going to select that smart object with the video. So Control T or Command T for free transform. And I'm going to hold down Shift. Well, actually, I don't really need to hold down Shift. I'm just rotating this into position. Now I'll hit Shift to scale it. And we can put that rabbit where we want. Maybe turn it around a little bit more. And I'm just going to hit Enter. Now to make this fit, what we're going to do is we're just going to clip it to the mask underneath. And to do that, hold down the Alt or the Option key, and you'll notice you see that little arrow with a square on it. When we click, that'll clip it to the transparency of the layer underneath. All right, we're getting really, really close to our result. All right, and if we wanted to create, you know, some kind of a little bit of a shadow maybe, what we're gonna do is, if we look at it here, we hide that. Notice we've got everything there. We just wanna put a little bit of a shadow maybe on those hands. So why don't we go up here? We're just going to create a new layer above everything, and I'm just going to select here. I'm just going to click, and what that does is that selects that area inside of there. And you know, I could, there's different ways of doing it, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab a brush right now, soft edge brush, drop it down to about 30% opacity, and you know what, I'm just kind of looking at it. The light source is coming pretty much from this direction here. See the shadow on her arm? We want to kind of match that. So I'm just going to paint in a little bit of a shadow on the edge of her hand right there. In fact, why don't we take this up to 100% opacity, and I'm just going to paint around there, and we can just kind of see where it's going, the direction it's going there. And I'm just kind of doing this by hand, just because it's does a job for me. You know, there's different ways you could do this with layer styles and whatnot, but I just want to kind of make it a little bit more custom. Control D, And then what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to take that area of shadow and I'm just going to bring it down a little bit with the opacity. So there we go. Just kind of blends it in a little bit. And so it kind of looks like she's on top of the book. Now the thing we need to do is we need to make it video it once again. So we're just going to create the video timeline. And you'll notice we've got our layers. So I'm just going to drag out that top layer there to make sure that matches everything. And let's have a look in the layers panel here. And we also want to make sure our background lasts the full length. Now we could turn this on to looping if we want, which it is. And we can see we've got a 16-second playback. It doesn't really need to be that long. I'm just going to hit the shift key and I'm just going to let it kind of play. And you can see we've got this animated book there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give it a second, because notice it's showing here it's only playing 7 frames per second. And that green line there is showing RAM preview. So what's happening is it's loading this video into RAM. Once it's complete, what it's going to do is it's going to loop back and play it back in real time. Okay, and now it's loaded into RAM preview. You can see, there we go. Now it's playing back in real time. And we've got our little book there. All right, and we have another option. If we wanted to show the leaves of the book a little bit better, what we could do is just select it here. And then what I would do is just grab my lasso tool. I'm going to use the polygon lasso. And what we're going to do is just grab those leaves. So this is just another kind of an option here. We're just going to mask these areas out. So if I just select that mask and fill that with black, and then we do the same thing up here. Let's select right there and go to those edges. This is just an alternative, and we just hit enter, and then we're going to fill that with black. And what it's going to do is it's actually just going to clip it out into that area of the book, which kind of gives it a different look. And then the other thing we could do, if you wanted, you could try a different blend mode, like maybe multiply blend mode, and you could actually show the rabbit on the pages like that, and we can see we get a different effect altogether. So as you can see, there's a lot of different things you can do with this to get the look that you like. You could go more comic book or more realistic. I've just kind of given you a few options. This is kind of a good springboard for you to play around and try some different things animating this book. All right, we've created our animation. So how do we get it out of here into a video? It's actually really simple. All we need to do is just choose File, and then we're just going to choose to Export, and then we're going to Render Video. And then when we go to the render video here, we'll just give it a name. I'm just going to call it comic book, even though it's more of an animated book. And, you know, we could select a folder here. I'm just going to drop it on my desktop. And then what we're going to do is just go under the default settings here, which is H.264 Adobe Media Encoder. And then we can just grab a preset. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down to YouTube 1080p. And I'm just going to select there. And then just click render. And then what it's going to do now is it's going to create that video right now. It'll take a little bit of time to do it, but you saw it at the very beginning of this video, and essentially just grab the preset you want for whatever you want, and it's going to automatically size and letterbox it for you. So it's super easy. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget, become part of the Cafe crew. Hit that subscribe button right now, become a subscriber, and then you're going to get a new video from me every single week on Photoshop, Lightroom, and occasionally on drones and gadgets. So if you like this, hit that thumbs up, hit that like button right now, and add a comment. What do you think about this? Do you like this kind of tutorial? What kind of tutorials would you like to see in the future? Let me know, and just, you know, let's get a discussion going about working with video and animation and stuff. And if it's something you guys want, I'd be happy to do more videos like this. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Until next week, I'll see you at the cafe.